Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Beauty by Chick Hien. My name is Hien. Today I'm going to share with you guys my March favorites and unfavorites. So let's get started. These are my favorites. These are my favorite three nail polishes this month. It's very summery, so I love them. This one's from Sally Hansen in Mint Sorbet. It's a mint green color. It's very, very nice. And two are from julep.com. I'll link it below if you guys are interested in viewing what they offer. Right, so this one has gold and silver speckles in it. It's called Vivien, and this one is turquoise with a little bit of gold in it. It's what I'm wearing today, and it's in Harper. Definitely look into the site and pick some up. My favorite foundation this month, of course, is the MAC Mineralize SPF 15 foundation in 37. I just cannot get over how awesome this foundation is. It's a must try if you guys have dry skin and is interested in a satin dewy finish. My favorite concealer this month is the Laura Mercier Undercover Pot in number 2. It has two colors. One has a pink undertone for your under eye circles, and one is more of a skin color, for your blemishes, okay? And underneath, it has a powder to set your concealer, so it's very travel friendly. My favorite blush this month has got to be the MAC in Warm Soul Baked Blush. I really, really like this because it's mineralized and it's like a pink color with golden in it. It's really nice. So definitely try it if you guys love MAC blushes. My favorite eyeshadow palette has to go to the Sigma Paris for this month. I've been using it the most out of all my palettes. As you can see, there's a lot of range in colors, very bright, very neutral, blushes, and a highlighter. So I really have been using this a lot. It's what I'm wearing, it's what I use today for my look. I'm using Notre Dame on my lid, Ellis's on my outer V, a little bit of the Eiffel also on my outer V. And underneath my lash line, I'm wearing Orsay. Till here, and then in the inner lash line, I'm wearing Versailles. And my brushes this month. My favorite brushes, most are from Sigma. Definitely the F80 brush for foundation, the F40 for contouring, the E30 for the eyeliner and underneath my eyes, my lash line, and the concealer brush to apply my under eye circles and also put concealer around my eyebrows. I love this brush to death. Right. This brush, however, is not from Sigma, but it's just equally as functional and one of my favorites this month. It's great for blending. It's from Soho. I got this in my Ipsy Glam bag a couple months back, so that's how I was introduced to Soho. I definitely am going to pick up some more of this blending brush from that company. It's a little ergonomic thing right there to place your fingers. It's awesome. Alright, non-beauty favorites this month. I used to be addicted to these Trader Joe's dried fruit chili spiced mangoes for the longest time, a couple years ago. I used to eat like one bag a day. That's how crazy I was. Anyways, I stopped it, and then I got back onto this addiction this month. Definitely pick it up if you guys are interested in dried fruit mango. Okay, and my second favorite that's non-beauty is this juice from Welch. Welch's. It's their juice cocktail, orange, pineapple, and apple. My roommates, my boyfriend, and I adore this juice. We go through it faster than we go through toilet paper. So, it's delicious. Okay. I'm going to share with you the last favorite non-beauty product afterwards, after my unfavorites video, because it's just straight up awesome and I want to put a lot of time with that object. Anyways, let's go to my unfavorites of this month, stuff that I did not like. Number one would be this Missha number 23 Perfect Cover BB Cream. A lot of people love this item. My friend, one of my good friends, recommended this for me. I just cannot stand this product. It smells really bad, and it has a gray finish, like a gray-based finish that a lot of people say that will go away after your skin oxidizes with this product, but my skin stayed gray for hours. It made me look pale, it made me look sick, so I'm definitely not going to use this product anymore. I might just have to give it to my friend and see if they like it, so then at least the product is used. Sorry, my dog is going crazy. Okay. Second unfavorite would be these e.l.f. Long Lasting Lustrous Eyeshadows in Gala and Festive. They're very pretty colors, but they're not as pigmented as I would like them to be. So for that, I'm going to give it to somebody else because I'm not going to use it at all. And also, I got this in a sample, and thank God I got it in a sample, because if I had bought this product, I would have been pissed. This is the MAC Volcanic Ash Exfoliator. Because I have dry skin, the lovely MAC artist recommended this to me, and she gave me a sample of this and a couple others that I reviewed in my MAC haul. But anyways, I hated this so much. It was like rubbing little rock particles all over my skin. I didn't think it got any softer, and I don't think it helped my skin at all. And I hate the smell. I really, really hate the smell. I cannot stand it. I might just have to trash this because I'm not going to give a sample to my friend. But anyways, that's another thing. Alright, so another unfavorite thing is what I ordered from Philosophy's website when I had a 40% discount. A lot of my friends told me to try this Purity Made Simple facial cleanser, one-step facial cleanser. So I thought I'd buy the biggest bottle since I had 40% off, but I just opened the package today and I was really saddened by it because, as you can tell, the cap broke off into pieces all over my box, all in my box. And yeah, like, I mean, it comes with a pump that has a screw on top, so it's not a big deal because I have to remove this to put this on. But still, like, as you can see, it's punctured right there. So it could have, like, broken the seal, got it contaminated, spilled everywhere, and no. But I'm definitely going to use this regardless because the seal is still there, so it's not contaminated. So I hope I like it because I bought it in 32 fluid ounces, so it's a lot of product. So I hope I like it, so then I would use it. And also I got from philosophy.com was Hope in a Jar for Dry Skin, because I'm also on the market for a moisturizer. And same thing with this packaging. I just don't understand. There's like a huge crack going all over my lid of the product, like this big. And thankfully it has a seal also, but why are all my packages with cracked lids? Like, I don't like that. But anyways, hopefully I like the product. I'll definitely let you guys know in my next month if I don't like it. Anyways, okay, so I'm on the last thing that I love this month. My boyfriend had purchased this for me for our 3-year anniversary. Love him so much. And I love this bag so much. I love this bag. It's my Rebecca Minkoff in mint. It's called the Jayden. And yeah, what's not to love? You love the color, I love the bag, I love the interior, I love the style, I love this bag. Anyways, I'm going to zip it up to show you guys what it looks like, front, back, upside down, whatever. Here's the bag, it's so cute. The sides, it has her signature long tassel. It's so cute. Like that. The bag underneath. Yeah, and if I want, I can wear it like this, just push down the sides, or I can wear it like this. Anyways, I'll show you guys the inside. Look at the inside. Like, look at this interior. This interior is awesome. It has two slots for your phone, all of that, and a pocket in the back. It's very spacious. It's a good travel bag, travel purse. Yeah, I love this bag. It's made from real leather. It's in the color mint. I had my eyes on this bag a couple weeks ago when Rebecca Minkoff on Instagrammed her Mad About Mint photo. It had this bag, the Morning After Mob. Morning After, is it called a mob? Mob? Mab? Something like that. It had that in mint, and it had the popular one, the MAC, in mint also. But I love this look of the bag. When I first got it, I was just like, this is so big, it doesn't look as big in the picture. And I was going to exchange it for the Swing, which is a really cute bag also that I have my eyes on for next time. But so happy that I got this bag from my boyfriend. It's so cute. Anyways, that concludes my favorites of March and unfavorites of March. And to add a little extra oomph to this video, I'm going to let you guys meet my dog, Max, and what his favorite things are this month. So, further ado, I'll see you guys next time, alright? Bye! This is Max. He's a Jindo. My little baby, the love of my life. But his favorite treat this month, which I got on sale, is the Baked Delights in bacon and cheese. I have one on my hand. Let's show Max. Maxie. Maxie.